हेलो एवरीवन, आज हम पढ़ेंगे क्लास टेंथ हिस्ट्री का चैप्टर नंबर 1, द राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप। इस वीडियो में हम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स को पढ़ेंगे जो 3 कैटेगरी में है, वेरी शॉर्ट, शॉर्ट और लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन आंसर। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं वेरी शॉर्ट आंसर्स से। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, विच फ्रेंच आर्टिस्ट प्रिपेयर्ड अ सीरीज ऑफ 4 प्रिंट विजुलाइजिंग हिज ड्रीम ऑफ अ वर्ल्ड। आंसर, फ्रेडरिक सोरियो। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय एब्सोल्यूटिस्ट। आंसर, एब्सोल्यूटिस्ट लिटरली अ गवर्नमेंट और सिस्टम ऑफ रूल दैट हैज नो रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन द पावर एक्सरसाइज्ड। इन हिस्ट्री द टर्म रेफर्स टू अ फॉर्म ऑफ मोनार्चिकल गवर्नमेंट दैट वॉज सेंट्रलाइज्ड, मिलिटराइज्ड एंड रिप्रेसिव। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज अ उटोपियन। आंसर, उटोपियन इज अ विजन ऑफ सोसाइटी दैट इज सो आइडियल दैट इट इज अनलाइकली टू एक्चुअली एग्जिस्ट। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर एडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ नेशन। स्टेट वन एडवांटेज। आंसर, द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ नेशंस इज अ गारंटी ऑफ लिबर्टी विच कुड बी लॉस्ट इफ द वर्ल्ड हैड ओनली वन लॉ एंड ओनली वन मास्टर। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज प्लेबिसाइट। आंसर, प्लेबिसाइट इज अ डायरेक्ट वोट बाय विच ऑल द पीपल ऑफ अ रीजन आर आस्क्ड टू एक्सेप्ट और रिजेक्ट अ प्रपोजल। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट पॉलिटिकल एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल चेंजेस डिड टेक प्लेस इन द वेक ऑफ द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन इन 1789। आंसर, द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन लेड टू द ट्रांसफर ऑफ सॉवरेनिटी फ्रॉम द मोनार्ची टू अ बॉडी ऑफ फ्रेंच सिटीजन। द रेवोल्यूशन प्रोक्लेम्ड दैट इट वॉज द पीपल हु वुड हैंसफोर्थ कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द नेशन एंड शेप इट्स डेस्टिनी। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, स्टेट एनी वन स्टेप दैट कुड क्रिएट अ सेंस ऑफ कलेक्टिव आइडेंटिटी अमंग द फ्रेंच पीपल। Answer, the ideas of the fatherland and the citizen emphasized the notion of a united community enjoying equal rights under a constitution. Next question, which clubs were set up after the French Revolution and by whom? Answer, as the news of events in France reached the different cities of Europe, students and other members of educated middle classes begin setting up Jacobin Club. Next question, how the Napoleon Code was implemented in the regions under French control? Answer, in the Dutch Republic, in Switzerland, in Italy and Germany, Napoleon simplified administrative divisions, abolished the feudal system and freed peasants from serfdom and manorial dues. Next question, why did the people in the conquered territories become hostile to Napoleon's rule? Answer, the people became hostile due to increased taxation, censorship, forced conscription into the French armies required to conquer the rest of Europe. All these seemed to outweigh the advantage of the administrative changes. Next question, in Austria-Hungary in the mid-18th century, there were different groups, languages, etc. In such a situation, what was the binding tie between them? Answer, the only tie binding the diverse groups together was a common allegiance to the emperor. Next question, what was the meaning of liberalism in early 19th century in Europe? Answer, the term liberalism is derived from the Latin word libre, meaning free. Thus, for the new middle classes, liberalism stood for freedom for the individual and equality of all before the law. Politically, it emphasized the concept of government consent. Next question, what do you mean by suffrage? Answer, suffrage means right to vote, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु हैड क्रिएटेड आउट ऑफ काउंटलेस स्मॉल प्रिंसिपैलिटीज अ कॉन्फेडरेशन ऑफ 39 स्टेट्स ऑफ जर्मनी? आंसर, नेपोलियन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन 1834 विच कस्टम यूनियन वॉज फॉर्म्ड, हु ज्वाइंड इट? आंसर, इन 1834 अ कस्टम्स यूनियन ज़ोलिब्रिट इन वॉज फाइंड फॉर्म्ड. द यूनियन वॉज ज्वाइंड बाय मोस्ट ऑफ द जर्मन स्टेट्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट डू यू मीन बाय कंजर्वेटिज्म? आंसर, कंजर्वेटिज्म इज अ पॉलिटिकल फिलॉसफी दैट स्ट्रेस द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ ट्रेडिशन, एस्टेब्लिश्ड इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड कस्टम्स एंड प्रिफर्ड ग्रेजुअल डेवलपमेंट टू क्विक चेंज. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच कांग्रेस वॉज हेल्ड इन 1815, बाय हूम वॉज इट होस्टेड? आंसर, कांग्रेस ऑफ वियना वॉज हेल्ड इन 1815. द कांग्रेस वॉज होस्टेड बाय द ऑस्ट्रियन चांसलर ड्यूक मेटर्निक. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट वॉज द पॉलिसी अडॉप्टेड एट वियना 1815 अबाउट द मोनार्चीज दैट हैड बीन ओवरथ्रॉन बाय नेपोलियन? आंसर, द मेन इंटेंशन वॉज टू रिस्टोर द मोनार्चीज दैट हैड बीन ओवरथ्रॉन बाय नेपोलियन एंड क्रिएट अ न्यू कंजर्वेटिव ऑर्डर इन यूरोप. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु वॉज गिस्यूपी मेजिनी? आंसर, गिस्यूपी मेजिनी वॉज द इटालियन रेवोल्यूशनरी हु फाउंडेड यंग इटली इन मर्सलीज एंड यंग यूरोप इन बर्न 1833. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट वॉज द रिजल्ट ऑफ जुलाई 1830 रेवोल्यूशन इन फ्रांस? आंसर, बाय जुलाई 1830 रेवोल्यूशन इन फ्रांस द बॉर्बन किंग हु हैड बीन रिस्टोर्ड टू पावर ड्यूरिंग द कंजर्वेटिव रिएक्शन आफ्टर 1815 वर ओवरथ्रोन बाय लिबरल रेवोल्यूशनरीज एंड इंस्टॉल्ड अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोनार्च अंडर लुइस फिलिप. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट वॉज सेड अबाउट मेजिनी बाय मेटर्निक? आंसर, मेटर्निक डिस्क्राइब्ड हिम एज द मोस्ट डेंजरस एनिमी ऑफ आवर सोशल ऑर्डर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट मेटर्निक रिमार्क्ड अबाउट इवेंट्स इन फ्रांस? आंसर, मेटर्निक वंस रिमार्क्ड, व्हेन फ्रांस स्नीज द रेस्ट ऑफ द यूरोप कैच्स कोल्ड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु वॉज लॉर्ड बायन? What was his contribution in the Greek War of Independence? Answer, Lord Byron was an English poet. He organized funds and later went to fight in the war where he died of fever in 1824. Next question, what was Romanticism? Answer, Romanticism was a cultural movement which sought to develop a particular form of nationalist sentiment. Romantic artists and poets generally criticized the glorification of reason and science and focused instead on emotions, institutions and mystical feelings. Next question, what was contribution of Karol Kurpinski in the freedom struggle of Poland? Answer, Karol Kurpinski celebrated the national struggle through his operas and music, turning folk dances like the Polonaise and Mazurka into nationalist symbols. Next question, give one reason for the great economic hardship in Europe in the 1830s. Answer, there was enormous increase in population all over Europe. In most countries, there were more seekers of jobs than employment. Next question, who were Grimm brothers? Why did they collect folk tales? Answer, the Grimm brothers were born in the German city of Hanau in 1785 and 1786 respectively. They collected folktales and considered their projects of collecting folktales and developing the German language as part of the wider effort to oppose French domination and create a German national identity. Next question, what happened in 1848 revolution in France? Answer, Louis Philippe was forced to flee and National Assembly proclaimed a republic. Suffrage was granted to all adult males above 21. Right to work was guaranteed. National workshops to provide employment were set up. Next question, define feminist. Answer, feminist means awareness of women's rights and interest based on the belief of the social, economic, and political equality of the genders. Next question, what is ideology? Answer, ideology is a system of ideas reflecting a particular social and political vision. Next question, who were Junkers in Prussia? Answer, large landowners were called Junkers in Prussia. Next question, who was the architect of the unification of Germany and which policy was adopted by him? Answer, Otto von Bismarck is considered the architect of German unification. He followed the policy of blood and iron to achieve his object. Next question, after unification of Germany, which policies were adopted by the new state? Answer, the new state placed a strong emphasis on modernizing the currency, banking, legal and judicial system in Germany. Prussian measures and practices often became a model for the rest of the Germany. Next question, name three persons who played an important role in the unification of Italy. Answer, Cavour, Mazzini, Garibaldi. Next question, what happened in England in 1688? Answer, glorious revolution had taken place. As a result of this, the English Parliament had seized power from the monarchy. Question, what is the importance of the Act of Union 1707? Answer, the Act of Union 1707 between England and Scotland had resulted in the formation of the United Kingdom of Great Britain. Next question, how attributes of liberty and justice were represented during French Revolution? Answer, the attributes of liberty were the cap or the broken chain. Justice is generally a blindfolded man carrying a pair of weighing scales. Next question, what did become the allegory of the German nation? How was it represented visually? Answer, Germania became the allegory of the German nation. In visual representations, Germania wears a crown of oak leaves as German oak stands for heroism. Next question, which was the most serious source of nationalist tension in Europe after 1871? Answer, it was the area called the Balkans. It was a region of geographical and ethnic variations comprising modern-day Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, Greece, Macedonia, Croatia, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Slovenia, Serbia, and Montenegro, whose inhabitants were broadly known as the Slavs. Next question, what made the Balkans an explosive region? Answer, the spread of the ideas of romantic nationalism in the Balkans, together with the disintegration of the Ottoman Empire, made this region very explosive. Next question, which European powers had rivalries in the Balkans and were keen on countering the hold of other powers over the Balkans and extending over own control over the area? Answer: Russia, Germany, England, and Austro-Hungary. Next question. Name the treaty of 1832 that recognized Greece as an independent nation. Answer: The Treaty of Constantinople, 1832, recognized Greece as an independent nation. Next question. Name the event that mobilized nationalist feeling among the educated elite across Europe in 1830 to 1848. Answer. The event that mobilized nationalist feelings among the educated elite across Europe in 1830 to 1848 was the Greek War of Independence. Next question. What was the main aim of the revolutionaries of Europe during the year following 1815? Answer. The main aim of the revolutionaries of Europe during the years following 1815 was to oppose monarchical forms of government that had been established after the Congress of Vienna and to fight for liberty and freedom. Next question. Who remarked when France sneezes, the rest of Europe gets cold? Answer. Duke Metternich, the Austrian Chancellor, remarked, when France sneezes, the rest of Europe gets cold. Next question. Who was proclaimed the German Emperor in a ceremony held at Versailles in January 1871? Answer. Kaiser William I of Prussia was proclaimed the German Emperor in a ceremony held at Versailles in January 1871. Next question. What was the meaning of liberalism in early 19th century in Europe? Answer. For the new middle classes, liberalism stood for freedom for the individual and equality of all before the law. Politically, it emphasized the concept of government by consent. Economically, liberalism stood for the freedom of markets and the abolition of state-imposed restrictions on the movement of goods and capital. Next question. What was the main aim of the Treaty of Vienna of 1815? Answer. The Treaty of Vienna of 1815 was signed with the main aim of undoing most of the changes that had come about in Europe during the Napoleonic Wars. It was signed to re-establish conservative reasons in Europe. Next question. What was the strong demand of the emerging middle classes in Europe during 19th century? Answer. Men and women of liberal middle classes combined their demands for constitutionalism with national unification. Next question. Mention the proclamation of the French Revolution. Answer. The French Revolution proclaimed that it was the people who would constitute the nation and shape its destiny. Next question. Who founded the secret society Young Italy during the 1830s? Answer. Giuseppe Mazzini, an Italian revolutionary, founded secret society Young Italy during the 1830s. Next question. Name the female allegory representing the Republic of France. Answer. The female allegory representing the Republic of France is Marine. Next question. Name the female allegory of the German nation. Answer. The female allegory of the German nation is Germania. Next question. What was the result of the first upheaval that took place in France in July 1830? Answer. The first upheaval that took place in France in July 1830 resulted in the overthrowing of the Bourbon kings and installation of a constitutional monarch with Louis Philippe as its head. Short answer. Question number 1. how had the female figures become an allegory of the nation during the 19th century in Europe? Analyze. Answer. In the 19th century in Europe, the female figures become an allegory of the nation in the following ways. The artist in the 18th and 19th centuries in Europe wanted to represent a country as if it was a person. In other words, they wanted to personify the nation. Nations were represented as female figures. The female form did not belong to any particular woman in real life. It was an abstract idea which gave the nation a concentrate form. The female figure became an allegory of a nation. In France, the female form was given to the name of Marianne, which represented the nation. Her characteristics were red cap, the tricolor, and the cocked drawn from those of liberty and the republic. Similarly, Germania became the allegory of the German nation. Germania wears a crown of oak leaves because oak stands for heroism. Next question. How did the local people in the areas conquered by Napoleon react to French rule? Explain. Answer. The reactions of the local population to French rule were mixed, although the economic reforms introduced by Napoleon were welcomed by businessmen and small producers of goods. Initially, the French armies were welcomed in Holland, Switzerland, and in cities like Brussels as messenger of liberty. But they soon realized that administrative reforms did not go hand in hand with political reform, freedom. The people reacted against increased taxation and censorship. Local people had to serve in the French army to conquer other parts of Europe. These all seemed to outweigh the advantages of administrative changes. Next question. Explain the conditions that were viewed as obstacles to the economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes during the 19th century in Europe. Answer. The conditions that were viewed as obstacles to the economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes during the 19th century in Europe were: there were many states imposed restrictions on the movement of goods, capital, and people. Each confederation had its own system of weights and measures that evolved time-consuming calculations. Because of countless principalities, there were many check posts where custom duties were paid by the merchants. It resulted in price rise and delay in supply. Next question. What were Jacobins Club? How did their activities and campaigns help to spread the idea of nationalism abroad? Explain. Answer. Jacobin clubs were the political clubs that were set up by the educated middle class in all over Europe to replace autocratic regimes in Europe with democratic governments. They were inspired by the events in France. The activities and campaigns of these clubs paved the way for the French armies, which moved into Holland, Belgium, and Switzerland, and much of Italy in 1790. With the outbreak of revolutionary wars, the French armies carried the ideas of nationalism in foreign countries. Next question. Explain the contribution of Otto von Bismarck in German unification. Answer. Otto von Bismarck was the chief architect of German unification. He carried out the process with the help of Persian army and bureaucracy. He helped in infusing nationalism in the mind of the masses. Three wars for over 7 years were fought to seek the German nation and defeat of Austria, Denmark, and France. Bismarck initiated in proclaiming the new German nation under Kaiser Wilhelm I of Prussia. thus completing the process of German unification. Next question. Explain any three ways in which nationalist feeling were kept alive in Poland in the 18th and 19th century. Answer. Polish people used their culture in a big way. They strived hard to keep their national identity. Nationalist feeling were kept alive in Poland in the following ways. They used music to keep their unity and identity. Karol Kurpinski raised the national struggle by sting his Polish operas and music. Traditional dance form of Poland, Polonaise and Mazurka became their national symbols. In the region occupied by the Russia, Polish people used their language to develop nationalist feelings. It was used as a weapon of national resistance in church gathering and religious instructions. Next question. Explain the contribution of Giuseppe Mazzini in spreading revolutionary ideas in Europe. Answer. Italian revolutionary Giuseppe Mazzini was born in Genoa in 1807. He became a member of the secret society of the Carbonari. At the age of 24, he was sent into exile in 1831 for attempting a revolution in Liguria. He founded two underground societies, first Young Italy in Marseilles and Young Europe in Bern. The members of the society were drawn from Poland, France, Italy, and the German states. Mazzini strongly believed that God had intended nations to be the natural units of mankind. So Italy could not continue to be a patchwork of small states and kingdoms. It had to be forged into a single unified republic within a wider alliance of nations. This unification alone could be the basis of Italian liberty. Following his model, secret societies were set up in Germany, France, Switzerland, and Poland. Mazzini's relentless opposition to monarch and his vision of democratic republics frightened the conservatives. Metternich described him as the most dangerous enemy of our social order. Next question. Explain in 3 points how Ireland was incorporated into United Kingdom in 1801. Answer. Ireland was incorporated into United Kingdom in 1801 in the following ways. Ireland was deeply divided between Catholics and Protestants. The English helped the Protestants to establish dominance over the largely Catholic country. Catholics revolted against the dominance but were suppressed. Wolfe Tone and his United Irishmen led a revolt but failed. As the English nation grew in power and influence, Ireland's distinctive culture and language was suppressed. The new symbols like British flag, national anthem, and English language was promoted. Next question. Explain any three features of the nation-state that emerged in Europe in the 20th century. Answer. The following were the features of the nation-state that emerged in Europe in the 20th century. This period witnessed intense rivalry and groups were formed among nations over trade and colonies as well as naval and military might. Ottoman Empire had disintegrated and subject nationalities declared their independence. Colonies waged anti-colonial struggle which led to the independence of these nations. Next question. Describe the nature of nationalism in the last quarter of the 19th century. Answer. The nature of nationalism in the last quarter of the 19th century was as mentioned below. It no longer retained its idealistic liberal democratic sentiment of the first half of the century, but became a narrow creed with limited ends. During the period, nationalist groups become increasingly intolerant of each other and ever ready to go to war. The major European powers manipulated the nationalist aspirations of the subject peoples in Europe to further their own imperialist aims. Long answer. Question number one. Who was Frederick Soriot? Describe main features of the first print prepared by him in 1848. Answer. Frederick Soriot was a French artist who prepared a series of four prints visualizing his dream of a world made up of democratic and social republics, as he called them. The main features of the first print of the series were as mentioned below. It shows men and women of all ages of Europe and America offering homage to the Statue of Liberty. Liberty was personified as a female figure with the torch of enlightenment in one hand and the Charter of Rights of Man in the other. In the foreground are the shattered remains of the symbols of absolutist institutions. Procession is led by USA and Switzerland, who were already nation-states. Other people are following them. From heavens above, Christ, saint, and angels gaze upon the scene to symbolize fraternity among the nation of the world. In Soriot's utopian vision, the peoples of the world were grouped as distinct nations identified through their flags and national custom. Thus, many issues have been visualized by Soriot in his print, but it is vision that can be realized. Next question. Describe how the events in France affected the different cities in Europe. Answer. When the news of the events in France reached the different cities in Europe, it had the effects as mentioned below. Students and other members of educated middle classes began setting up Jacobin clubs. Their activities and campaigns prepared the way for the French armies, which moved into Holland, Belgium, Switzerland, and much of Italy in the 1790s. With the break of revolutionary wars, the French armies began to carry the idea of nationalism abroad. Next question. What were the reactions of the local populations to the French rule in the conquered territories? Answer. The reactions of the local peoples in the conquered territories by the French were mixed. In the beginning, in Holland, Switzerland, Brussels, Mainz, Milan, and Warsaw, people welcomed the French armies as harbingers of liberty. Political freedom was advantageous, but more taxes, censorship, and forced conscription into the French armies for conquering rest of Europe made local population hostile to them, because it became clear that the new administrative arrangements did not go hand in hand with political freedom. Increased taxation, censorship, forced conscription into the French armies required to conquer the rest of Europe all seemed to outweigh the advantages of the administrative changes. Next question. Describe the political condition of Europe in the mid-18th century. Answer. The political condition of Europe in the mid-18th century was as mentioned below. There were no nation-states. Germany, Italy, and Switzerland were divided into kingdoms, duchies, and cantons, whose rulers had their autonomous territories. There were autocratic monarchies in Eastern and Central Europe. People spoke different languages and belonged to different ethnic groups. For example, Habsburg Empire consisted of different regions and peoples. they did not share a collective identity or a common culture. It included German-speaking people of Bohemia, as well as Italian-speaking people of Lombardy and Venetia. Half of the population of Hungary was Magyar. Such differences did not promote a sense of political unity. The only tie-binding diverse groups together was a common allegiance to the emperor. Next question. Describe the condition of the aristocracy as peasantry in Europe in the mid-18th century. Answer. The condition of aristocracy and peasantry was, as mentioned below, landed aristocracy. Socially and politically, a landed aristocracy was the dominant class on the continent. They were united by a common way of life, such as owning large estates and town houses, use of French language for diplomacy, and in high society. They were also united with ties of marriage with each other. Thus, aristocracy was powerful, but they were in minority. Peasantry. The majority of the population was peasants. To the west, most of the land was farmed by tenants and small owners. In the eastern and central Europe, there were large estates which were cultivated by serfs. Next question. When did industrialization begin in Europe? What were its consequences? Answer. Industrialization. Industrialization had begun in England in the second half of the 18th century. However, it took place in France and parts of the German states during the 19th century. Its consequences were, as mentioned below, growth of towns, emergence of commercial classes. There was growth of towns and the emergence of commercial classes in Western and some parts of Western Europe. This was due to the growth of industrial production and trade. The existence of commercial classes was based on production for the market. A new working class and middle classes, consisting of industrialists, businessmen, professionals, came into existence. It was among the educated, liberal middle classes that ideas of national unity following the abolition of aristocratic privileges gained popularity. Next question. Who were granted the right to vote in France during the period of revolution? Answer. In France, the right to vote and election was granted only to property-owning men. Men without property and all women were excluded from political rights. During the periods of Jacobins, all adult males were granted right to vote. The Napoleonic Code again granted limited right to vote. Women were reduced to the status of a minor, subject to the authority of fathers and husbands. Women and non-propertied men organized opposition movements demanding equal political rights during the 19th and early 20th century. Next question. What was Zollverein? Why was it introduced? Describe its advantages. How did it strengthen nationalist sentiments in German states? Answer. Zollverein was a custom union that was formed in 1834 at the initiative of Prussia and was joined by most of the German states. Causes of introduction of Zollverein. In the first half of the 19th century, there were countless small principalities in the German-speaking region. Napoleon had created a confederation of 39 states. This confederation had many drawbacks, as mentioned below. Each had its own currency, weight, and measures. From Habsburg to Nuremberg, there were 11 custom barriers. Traders had to pay a custom duty at each barrier. ड्यूटी वॉज पेड अकॉर्डिंग टू वेट और मेजरमेंट. सो देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम इन कैलकुलेशन. द अबव कंडीशंस वर एन ऑब्स्टिकल इन इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. ट्रेडर्स एंड न्यू कॉमर्शियल क्लासेस वॉन्टेड मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स विदाउट एनी हिंड्रेंस. सो इन 1834 एट द इनिशिएटिव ऑफ प्रशिया ज़ोलबर्गिन वॉज फॉर्म्ड. एडवांटेजेस. इट वॉज फॉर्म्ड फॉर द क्रिएशन ऑफ अ यूनिफाइड इकोनॉमिक टेरिटरी अलाउइंग द अनहिंडर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स पीपल एंड कैपिटल. द यूनियन एबोलिश्ड टैरिफ बैरियर्स एंड रिड्यूस्ड द नंबर ऑफ करेंसीज फ्रॉम ओवर 30 to 2. अ नेटवर्क ऑफ रेलवेज वॉज क्रिएटेड विच इंक्रीज्ड मोबिलिटी harnessing economic interest to national unification. Industry grew due to free trade. It created a national unity in economic matters at a time when Germany was divided. It accustomed German states to cooperate without Austria, who had not become a member of Zollverein. It taught them the advantages of Persian leadership. It was the beginning of German unity. Thus, economic nationalism strengthened the wider nationalist sentiments. Next question. What do you understand by conservatism? Describe the object and decision of the Congress of Vienna and examine them too. Answer. Conservatism was a political philosophy that stressed the importance of tradition, established institutions and customs, and preferred gradual development to quick change. Objectives. After the defeat of Napoleon, the European powers, Britain, Russia, Prussia, and Austria, met at Vienna. It was hosted by the Austrian Chancellor, Duke Metternich. The object was to undo most of the changes that had taken place during the Napoleonic Wars. Decisions of the Congress. Some major decisions of the Congress were as given below. The Bourbon dynasty was restored in France. A number of states such as Netherlands, Piedmont were strengthened on the boundaries of France to prevent French expansion in future. Thus, Belgium was included in Netherlands and Genoa in Piedmont. Prussia was given important new territories on France's western frontiers. It got a portion of Saxony. Austria got control of northern Italy. Russia was given a part of Poland. She got most part of the Grand Duchy of Warsaw and retained Finland. Russia emerged with a good number of addition and extended further westward into European than ever. Evolution of the Congress. Conservative regimes set up in 1815 were autocratic. They did not tolerate criticism and dissent. They imposed censorship laws to control the newspapers, books, plays, and ideas of liberty and freedom. Next question. How did nationalism develop through culture in Europe? Or, culture has played an important role in the development of nationalism in Europe during 18th and 19th century. Support the statement with examples. Or, how did culture play an important role in the creating the idea of nation in Europe? Explain with examples. Or describe the role of culture in shaping the feeling of nationalism in Europe from 1830 to the end of 19th century. Answer. Culture played an important role in creating the idea of the nation. Art and poetry, stories and music helped express and shaped nationalist feeling. Romanticism helped in developing a particular form of nationalist sentiments. Romantic artists and poets generally criticized the glorification of reason and science. They focused on emotions. institutions and mystical feelings in order to create a sense of a shared collective heritage, a common culture past as the basis of a nation. German philosopher John Gottfried tried to popularize the true spirit of the nation through folk songs, folk poetry, and folk dances. The emphasis on vernacular language and the collection of local folklore was to recover an ancient national spirit and to carry the modern nationalist message to large audiences who were mostly illiterate. In Poland, which had been partitioned by the great powers, national feelings were kept alive through music and language. Karol Kurpinski celebrated the national struggle through his operas and music, turning folk dance like the Polonaise and Mazurka into nationalist symbols. Language, too, played an important role in the developing nationalist sentiments. After Russian occupation, the Polish language was forced out of school and Russian language was imposed everywhere. In 1831, an armed rebellion against Russian rule was crushed. After this, many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Polish was used for church gathering and all instructions. The use of Polish came to be seen as a symbol of the struggle against Russian dominance. As a result of it, a large number of priests and bishops were put in jail or sent to Siberia by the Russian authorities as punishment. But the use of Polish came to be seen as a symbol of the struggle against Russian dominance. Next question. The decade of 1830 had brought great economic hardship in Europe. Support that statement with arguments. Or why was the decade of 1813 was known as the great economic hardship in Europe? Explain any three reasons. Answer. The 1830s were the years of great economic hardship in Europe due to the following reasons. There was enormous increase in population all over Europe. There were more seekers of jobs than employment. People migrated from rural areas to the cities to live in overcrowded slums. There was stiff competition between the products of small producers and products imported from England, where goods were made by machines as industrialization had already taken place there. Peasants' condition was bad due to burden of feudal dues and obligations. The prices of food had risen due to bad harvest. This had resulted in widespread pauperism in town and country. Next question. What were the causes and effects of revolution of 1848 in France? Answer. Causes. In Europe, the 1830s were a year of great economic hardship. In 1848, too, there were food shortages and widespread unemployment. As a result of it, the population of Paris demonstrated, barricades were erected. Result, Louis Philippe abdicated the throne, France became a republic, suffrage was granted to all adult males above 21 years, right to work was guaranteed, national workshops to provide employment were set up, thus another revolution had taken place in France, which changed the government from monarchy to a republic. Next question. Describe the causes of the Silesian weavers' uprising. What were its results? Answer. Causes of the Silesian weavers' uprising. The cause of the uprising was the exploitation of the weavers by the contractors. They had reduced the payments to the weavers for the goods they ordered. There was already widespread unemployment and they were living a life of extreme misery. Results: a contractor, when attacked, tried to get shelter in neighboring village but failed. He sought the help of army. In the exchange between the army and the weavers, 11 weavers were killed. Importance: the weavers' uprising depict the condition of people in the villages. There was extreme poverty and unemployment. People were exploited by rich people. Army also helped them to crush such uprising or opposition. Thus, the government did not care for the welfare of the poor. Question: how was the history of nationalism in Britain unlike the rest of Europe? Answer: the history of nationalism in Britain was unlike the rest of Europe in the following ways. It was not the result of wars, as was in Germany, but a long drawn out process. Different ethnic groups, English, Welsh, Scot, and Irish, had their own cultural and political traditions, but the English nation, in course of time, was able to extend its influence over the other nations of the island due to her wealth, importance, and power. As a result of Glorious Revolution in 1688, the English Parliament was the instrument through which a nation state with England as its center came to be forged. The Act of Union 1707 formed United Kingdom of Great Britain, as the majority of the members of British Parliament were English members. A policy of repression was followed against Catholic clans of Scottish Highlands. In Ireland too, similar policy was followed. There were Catholics as well as Protestants. Catholic revolts were suppressed, and ultimately in 1801, Ireland was incorporated into the United Kingdom. A new British nation was forged through the propagation of a dominant English culture. The symbols of the new British Britain: the British flag, Union Jack; the national anthem, God Save Our Noble King. The English language were actively promoted, and the older nations survived only as subordinate partners in the Union. Next question: what was the area of the Balkans? Why was it the most serious source of nationalist tension in Europe after 1871? What was its result? Answer: the Balkans was a region of geographical and ethnic variation, comprising modern-day Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, Greece, Macedonia, Croatia, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Slovenia, Serbia, and Montenegro, whose inhabitants were broadly known as Slavs. Causes for being the most serious source of nationalist tension in Europe in 1871 were as mentioned below. A large part of the Balkans were under the control of the Ottoman Empire. However, with the weakening and disintegration of the Ottoman Empire, the nationalist tension emerged in the area. Its European subject nationalities broke away and declared their independence. The people of the Balkans argued that they were once independent before the foreign powers controlled them, so their object was to regain their lost independence. Nationalist tensions emerged due to rivalries of the European powers like Russia, England, Germany, Austria, Hungary. All of these powers wanted to have their control due to one reason or the other. Them, rivalries among the Balkan states. The Balkan states were fiercely jealous of each other, and each one of them wanted to extend her territory at the expense of the others. Results: rivalries of the European powers and among the Balkan states led to a series of wars in the region and finally the First World War. Next question. Analyze the measures and practices introduced by the French revolutionaries to create a sense of collective identity amongst the French people. Answer: the measures and practice introduced by the French revolutionaries to create a sense of collective identity among the French people were as follows: the idea of La Patrie, the fatherland, and Le Citoyen, the citizen, emphasized the idea of united people enjoying equal rights under a constitution. A new French flag, the tricolor, was chosen to replace the former royal standard. The States General was elected by the active citizens and renamed the National Assembly. New hymns were composed, oaths taken, and martyrs commemorated in the name of nation. Regional dialects were discouraged, and French, as it was spoken and written in Paris, became the common language of the nation. A centralized administrative system was put in practice, and it formulated uniform law for all citizens within its territory. Internal customs duties and dues were abolished, and a uniform system of weights and measures was adopted. Next question. Napoleon had destroyed democracy in France, but in the administrative field he had incorporated revolutionary principles in order to make the whole system more rational and efficient. Analyze the statement with arguments. Answer: Napoleon declared himself the Emperor of France and destroyed democracy. In the administrative field, he incorporated revolutionary principles, which were as follows: the Civil Code of 1804, also known as Napoleonic Code, abolished all the privileges based on birth, established equality before the law, and gave the right to property. The code, which was introduced in the religious regions under French control, like Italy, Germany, Switzerland, simplified administrative divisions, abolished the feudal system and freed peasants from serfdom and manorial dues. In towns, guild restrictions came to be an end. Uniform weights and measures were adopted. A common national currency helped in the movement of goods and capital from one region to another. Transport and communication system were improved. Next question. Nationalism no longer retained its idealistic liberal democratic sentiments by the last quarter of the 19th century in Europe. Analyze the statement with examples. Answer: towards the end of the 19th century, nationalism became a narrow belief with inadequate ends. This period saw nationalist groups becoming increasingly prejudiced of each other and ready to wage a war at the slightest of the pretext. Nationalism was now identified with increasing one's sphere of influence by establishing control over more territories. Balkan states became jealous of each other and entered into a conflict to establish more control and power in the region at the cost of others. The chief European authorities saw this as an opportunity and manipulated the nationalist desires of the subject peoples. European powers were keen on countering the hold of other powers over the Balkans. They did nothing serious to solve the Balkan issue, rather was the situation to turn fruitful for them. The most severe tensions emerged after 1871, leading to a series of wars and ultimately led to the First World War in 1914. Next question. Describe the process of unification of Germany. Answer: process of unification of Germany. By 1848, the popular effort of political associations failed in installing a constitution monarch in Germany. The failure of Frankfurt Parliament made it clear that German unification had to come through the combined effort of monarchy and the army supported by large landowners. From 1848, Prussia took on the leadership of the movement of national unification. In this process, Otto Bismarck, the chief minister of Prussia, proved to be the main architect. Bismarck reached his goal with the help of Persian army and the bureaucracy. He fought 3 wars in 7 years with Austria, Denmark, and France, which ended in Prussia victory and completed the process of German unification. Next question. Nationalism spread when people begin to believe that they are all part of the same nation. Support the statement. Answer. The term nationalism refers to the feeling of oneness based on common heritage and common identity and a sense of belonging to one's nation. The spirit of nationalism can spread and develop only when people discover some bond or unity that binds them together. The sense of collective belonging develops through the experience of united struggles. There are a variety of cultural processes through which nationalism captures people's imagination. History and fiction, folklore and songs, popular prints and symbols all play a role in the spirit of nationalism. Any image or symbol that is identified as nation is also recognized as a bond and help in the spirit of nationalism. Next question. Describe the process of unification of Italy. Answer. During the middle of the 19th century, Italy was divided into 7 states, of which only Sardinia Piedmont was ruled by Italian princely house. Mazzini, a great revolutionary leader of Italy, inspired the youth with the ideas of establishing a single unified Italy. He set up secret societies like Young Italy in Marseilles and Young Europe in Bern with like-minded young men from Poland, France, Italy and German states. Mazzini prepared the ground for Cavour to complete the process of unification. After a series of failures of Mazzini, King Victor Emmanuel II took to unifying Italy through wars. Cavour, the chief minister, through his tactful diplomatic alliance with France, defeated Austrian forces in 1859. Under the leadership of Giuseppe Garibaldi, armed volunteers marched into South Italy in 1860 along with the kingdom of Two Sicilies and won the support of local peasants and drove the Spanish away. Thus, unifying Italy in 1861, Victor Emmanuel II was made the king of United Italy. Next question. Describe the process of unification of Britain. Answer. In Britain, the formation of a nation state was not the result of a sudden upheaval, revolution or national struggle, but of a long drawn out parliamentary process. England had people of many ethnic groups such as English, Welsh, Scot and Irish with their own cultural and political traditions. The English nation still grew in importance, wealth and power and extended her influence over other nations of the island. The British Parliament, which had seized power from the monarchy in 1688, was the instrument through which a nation-state with England at the center came to be forged. The Act of Union of 1707 between England and Scotland resulted in the formation of United Kingdom of Great Britain, Ireland, after a prolonged conflict between Irish Catholics and British Protestants were forcibly incorporated into the United Kingdom in 1801. The symbols of the New Britain, the British flag, Union Jack, the national anthem and the English language were actively promoted. Next question. How had revolutionaries spread their ideas in many European states after 1815? Explain with examples. Answer. After the Congress of Vienna in 1815, when conservative regimes were restored to power, मैनी लिबरल माइंडेड पीपल वेंट अंडरग्राउंड बिकॉज ऑफ द फियर ऑफ रिप्रेशन. सीक्रेट सोसाइटीज स्प्रंग अप इन यूरोपियन स्टेट्स टू ट्रेन द रेवोल्यूशनरीज एंड स्प्रेड देयर आइडियाज. मैनी रेवोल्यूशनरीज अपोज मोनार्चिकल रूल एंड फाउट फॉर लिबर्टी एंड फ्रीडम ऑफ देयर रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट्स. वन सच रेवोल्यूशनरी वॉज गिसिपी मेज़िनी, एन इटालियन पेट्रियॉट वॉज सेंट टू एग्जाइल इन 1831 फॉर अटेम्प्टिंग अ रेवोल्यूशन इन लिगुरिया. ही बिकेम द मेंबर ऑफ अ सीक्रेट सोसाइटी कार्बोनरी. ही फाउंडेड टू अंडरग्राउंड सोसाइटीज, फर्स्ट यंग इटली इन मर्सलीज एंड द अदर यंग यूरोप इन बर्न. द सोसाइटी हैड मेंबर फ्रॉम पोलैंड, फ्रांस, इटली, जर्मनी एटसेट्रा. द मेंबर्स बिलीव्ड इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ नेशन स्टेट्स एंड देवर लिबरल माइंडेड पीपल. फॉलोइंग द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इटली, सीक्रेट सोसाइटीज वर सेटअप इन जर्मनी, फ्रांस, स्विट्जरलैंड, पोलैंड. मेज़िनीज विजन ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक रिपब्लिक्स फ्राइटेंड द कंजर्वेटिव्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एक्सप्लेन एनी फोर चेंजेस ब्रॉट डाउन अबाउट इन यूरोप बाय द ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना 1815. आंसर, नेपोलियन वॉज डिफीटेड इन 1815 बाय कलेक्टिव यूरोपियन पावर्स लाइक ब्रिटेन, रशिया, प्रशिया एंड ऑस्ट्रिया. द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ यूरोपियन पावर ड्रू अप द ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना एट द कांग्रेस होस्टेड बाय ऑस्ट्रियन चांसलर ड्यूक मेटर्निक विद द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अंडूइंग द चेंजेस दैट हैड कम अबाउट द यूरोप ड्यूरिंग द नेपोलियनिक वॉर्स. फॉलोइंग चेंजेस वर ब्रॉट अबाउट इन यूरोप बाय दिस ट्रीटी. द बॉनवन Density was destroyed during the French Revolution, was restored. French lost the territories it has annexed under Napoleon. A series of states were set up on the boundaries of France to prevent French expansion in future. The Netherlands, which included Belgium, was set up in the north. Genoa was added to Piedmont in the south. Prussia was given important new territories on its western frontiers. Austria was given control of northern Italy. Confederation of 39 states set up by Napoleon was left untouched. Russia was given part of Poland and Prussia was given part of Saxony. Monarchy was restored and a new conservative order was created in Europe. इसी के साथ ही हमारा ये वीडियो कंप्लीट होता है. हमें कमेंट करके ज़रूर बताएं कि आपको ये वीडियो कैसा लगा. साथ ही हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें जिससे आपके पास हमारे लेटेस्ट वीडियो के अपडेशन नोटिफिकेशन पहुंचते रहें. धन्यवाद.